In miniature painting, nearly everyone is talking about resin printers. But if you are like me and live in a small apartment with family and pet, resin printing isn't really an option. This is not an environment for toxic fumes and burning liquids. Additionally, MSLA printing requires more time and space due to the cleaning, curing and washing processes. This is why I've been considering an FDM printer for some time, and I finally gotten in touch with Prusa Research, who kindly supported the channel with the Core ONE machine. Right out of the box, the catch was the 205 pages instruction manual. And make me doubt, just by looking at all the motors, belts and extruder gearbox. But I was motivated to the challenge by desire to understand how these machines work and to troubleshoot any issues myself. The assembly kit is also a bit cheaper, so I thought it would be also interesting for you if you want to save some cash and have a cool project over the weekend. The unboxing was exciting. Mysterious boxes, labeled screws and small parts were very well organized in tiny bags, which was a lifesaver given the number of parts. Just like a giant Lego Technic set. And just like anyone would welcome a nice Lego set at home, this printer fits in as well. It has a sleek, modern and slightly cyberpunk look that fits well alongside my TV or Xbox in the living room. It's compact, with a filament spool that doesn't stick out, but it's hidden within the enclosure, which protects the printer from my cat and makes it safer to live with in a small apartment, where a lot of stuff is happening all the time. I will be also printing with PLA and PETG, which are considered to be the safest materials for making miniatures at home. The assembly was something more than I expected, which was a good thing. The printer was truly about to be put together from the tiniest of pieces. Every PCB board was about to be plugged and secured with heat transfer stickers. Every cable needed to be guided along the frame. Every gear had to be manually inserted, in the right place and order. And I really enjoyed the experience that Prusa prepared for us. The instructions guided me through the process very well, highlighting nuances that helped avoid problems. If you decide to get a kit like this for yourself, you might also want to pay attention to the comments section of the instruction, where people share their ideas. For instance, someone pointed out that it will be easier to align the rails horizontally to the bed if part of the frame with screw holes are used as a guide for proper height. Some difficulties, although not the ones I initially expected, like guiding the belts or assembling the extruder and gearbox. The most difficult part turned out to be the pesky side cover with the filament sersa, where I needed 3 tries before I managed to screw it in place, even with my high acrobatic and dexterity skill modifiers. The assembly process as a whole is pretty complicated, but you don't need to overthink it. Just take small steps, screw by screw, and from this perspective it's pretty manageable. Once the build was completed, it was time to turn it on for the first time. Unfortunately, my phone decided to forget how to focus, and in my panic, I didn't record it as the printer almost pulled out the cables from the mainboard. Turned out the heatbed cable was too long and got cut between the wall and the heatbed itself. Fortunately, the cable is protected by wrapping and a series of zip ties, so nothing serious happened. I fixed the issue and ran the first test print, immediately jumping to printing terrain. And even some 1-page loose miniatures. I was amazed that printing minis like this is even possible on FDM, and this was just an experiment with 0.4 nozzle and various layer heights. I even pushed this nozzle a little further than recommended, and I am about to switch to a smaller nozzle for better details and finish. After seeing what miniatures people are able to print, I'm pretty confident with an idea of fully FDM printed Alien Hives army for my 1-page loose battles. There is a lot to learn, but I am super excited about this idea. And I am also amazed that I managed to pull off this build. This experience has been entirely different from unboxing an already assembled machine. For a first timer, it truly felt like sci-fi adventure, even though the process was long, because I was also recording, switching angles and setting up lamps, and I had to get my cat out for the weekend, so he wouldn't kick everything around the house. I almost want to do it again. Subscribe, like, leave a comment, and watch this next video. This was Martin from Wardrobe Workshop. See you in the next one.